In the late 1970s, NASA's Viking Eye orbiter captured an image that would ignite imaginations around the globe. In the Cydonia region of Mars, a shadowed mesa appeared to resemble a human face, complete with eyes, a nose, and a mouth. The photo was released to the public not long after, and what might have been dismissed as a natural landform suddenly became the subject of wild speculation. News outlets ran the image with sensational headlines. Was this a monument left by an ancient civilization? Had we just stumbled across evidence of intelligent life beyond Earth? NASA's own description, calling it a mesa that looks like a human head, did little to dampen the flames. The photo became iconic, a kind of extraterrestrial Rorschach test. It was passed around in tabloids, discussed on talk shows, and featured in documentaries. For many, it was more than just a trick of light and shadow. It felt like contact. But as we'd later learn, the Martian face wasn't what it seemed. Still, the spark it lit would burn for decades, inspiring both serious research and fringe theories alike. And just as the story began to settle, science returned with new tools and even sharper eyes. Decades after the Viking, eye photographs shook the world. NASA returned to Cydonia with better technology. In the late 1990s and early 2000s, high-resolution images from Mars Global Surveyor and Mars Express painted a far clearer picture. The famous face was no longer a dramatic sculpture in the sand. It was just a weathered hill, a butte, shaped by natural forces over millions of years. From the right angle and in the right light, shadows had created the illusion of a human face. This phenomenon is known as pareidolia, the brain's tendency to find familiar patterns, like faces, in random or chaotic visuals. It's the same trick of perception that lets us see animals in clouds or figures in rock formations. On Mars, this effect was magnified by the low resolution of early images and the psychological hunger for contact with other civilizations. Once viewed in sharper detail, the Martian face was stripped of its mystique. What once looked like deliberate design now revealed itself as coincidence. No eyes, no mouth, just stone. Yet this revelation did little to erase the cultural impact. The myth had already taken root, and as we'll see, it wasn't the last time rocks on Mars would fool our eyes. Nearly half a century after Viking's mysterious photo, a new face appeared on Mars, this time caught by the Perseverance rover. The image, taken in 2024, showed a stone formation bearing a striking resemblance to a human face. High forehead, deep-set eyes, and even a mouth-like indentation. Once again, headlines buzzed. Social media lit up. Had we discovered another monument? But this time, things were different. Scientists were quick to explain the image as another case of pareidolia. The rock was a product of erosion, shaped by ancient wind and possibly flowing water. It was fascinating, but not artificial. Still, the speed with which the image spread showed that the idea of faces on Mars hadn't lost its power. People still wanted to believe. Interestingly, this new face was captured in a completely different region from Cydonia, near Jezero Crater. It reminded us that Mars has thousands of landforms, and the more we explore, the more familiar shapes we're bound to find. But just because something looks human doesn't mean it was made by humans, or anything like them. That said, one rock in particular stirred even more controversy. In early 2025, the Perseverance rover spotted a dark, rugged stone that immediately sparked public fascination. Its jagged features and hollowed eye-like sockets made it resemble a human skull. The image went viral. Some claimed it was a fossil, others insisted it had to be artificial. But NASA scientists were quick to investigate. Using instruments aboard Perseverance, including Supercam's laser analysis and Mastcam Z imagery, researchers identified the object's composition. It was a basaltic rock, likely volcanic in origin, rich in magnesium and olivine. Far from a skull, it was a product of Mars's geologic history. Cracks and pits created by erosion had sculpted a shape our brains recognized, but nature had done all the work. The rock, nicknamed Skull Hill, was a classic case of mistaken identity, but it offered something more valuable than mystery, clues about the planet's past. Its mineral content suggested volcanic activity and ancient environmental conditions that might once have supported water. The skull was not a sign of death, but a whisper from a planet still revealing its story. Yet, this wasn't the only strange formation in Jezero Crater that caught scientists' eyes. Among the many curious rocks Perseverance has encountered, few are as visually striking as the so-called Zebra Rock, also known as Freya Castle. With bold, alternating light and dark bands, this rock stands out sharply against the red Martian soil. Its layered appearance seems almost too precise, as if painted by hand. But as always, there's a geological explanation. Scientists believe the Zebra Rock is either a sedimentary or metamorphic formation, possibly carried from higher ground and deposited over time. Its striped texture likely comes from different mineral compositions layered over eons of pressure and change. Unlike the face or the skull, this formation doesn't mimic anything human. But it still raised questions, mainly about the forces that created it. The rock's origins may lie in ancient flows, perhaps from when water once moved through Jezero Crater. Studying its structure helps scientists piece together the puzzle of Mars's environmental history. It's a reminder that even without faces or symbols, Mars still tells a story, one layer at a time, and some of these layers are stranger than fiction. When meteorites strike Mars, the force of impact reshapes the surface in dramatic ways. These collisions create craters, shatter rocks, and hurl debris across vast distances. Over time, erosion can soften these features, sculpting strange and often symmetrical forms. Some of these formations appear almost deliberate. Pyramidal hills, cube-like boulders, or elongated ridges, but they're all part of a natural process. Impact sites often expose older layers of rock, revealing geological histories otherwise buried beneath the surface. Occasionally, the chaotic arrangement of fractured stones can resemble structures, a line of blocks here, a sharp edge there. But scientists are quick to explain, Mars has no tectonic plates like Earth. These shapes aren't the result of construction, but of violence. One well-documented case is an impact near the Elysium region, where fragmented stones formed a square-like outline. It made headlines briefly, until imaging and context confirmed it was nothing more than erosion and fracture patterns. Mars may seem to sculpt faces and walls, but it does so blindly, through heat, pressure, and time. And sometimes, wind adds the finishing touch. Mars is a planet of wind. Without oceans or dense vegetation, nothing stops the planet's constant breezes from shaping the landscape. Over millions of years, this ceaseless erosion carves rock into fantastic forms. Smooth arches, jagged towers, and curves that mimic the work of artists, all born from sand and time. These natural sculptures are sometimes mistaken for ruins, monuments, or tools. Wind erosion works differently on Mars than on Earth. Lower gravity and a thinner atmosphere mean dust and sand grains move in unique ways. Repeated collisions from these particles chip away at exposed surfaces. Over time, softer minerals wear down faster, leaving behind hard-edged features. This selective erosion explains why some formations look geometric or symmetrical. In places like the Medusae Fossae Formation, entire hillsides have been shaped into flowing, layered patterns. At first glance, they might resemble collapsed temples or collapsed walls, but they're simply nature's long, patient work. Wind has always been Mars's greatest sculptor, and it's still carving, even now. Yet beyond the wind and stone, perception itself plays a crucial role in what we think we see. Pareidolia is a psychological phenomenon where the mind finds familiar patterns, especially faces, in unrelated visuals. It's why we see animals in clouds or expressions in electrical outlets. Our brains are hardwired to detect faces quickly. On Earth, that instinct helps us read emotion and build trust. But on Mars, it misleads us. When we look at photos of Martian terrain, our pattern-seeking brain goes to work. A dark rock with two pits becomes a pair of eyes. A cracked ledge turns into a mouth. Add a bit of shadow, and the illusion is complete. Pareidolia isn't imagination. It's recognition run wild. Scientists studying Martian imagery are well aware of this bias. That's why they rely on multi-angle photos, spectral analysis, and 3D models before making conclusions. What looks like a statue in one image may become unrecognizable from another angle. Still, the human brain keeps seeing meaning in randomness, and Mars, with its endless shapes and shadows, provides the perfect canvas. Even trained researchers are not immune to pareidolia. That's why scientific methods matter. But public fascination with these illusions continues, especially in one place, Cydonia. The Cydonia region became famous thanks to Viking Y's photo. But beyond that single image, what is this place really? Cydonia lies in Mars's northern hemisphere, between smooth plains and rugged highlands. It's filled with mesas, buttes, and eroded hills, features shaped by billions of years of natural change. NASA has studied the region extensively. Its terrain suggests ancient water activity, possibly shallow seas or glacial movements long ago, but there are no signs of artificial structures. Later missions confirm this through topographic mapping and spectroscopy. The face is just one of many oddly shaped hills. Interestingly, other nearby formations also caught public attention, what looked like pyramids or aligned structures. But again, detailed analysis showed these were naturally formed. The angles and arrangements weren't mathematically precise or consistent. They were simply the result of erosion and coincidence. Cydonia's myth lives on in pop culture, but in the scientific world, it's a lesson in caution. Visual impressions are powerful, but they're not proof. And when you want to understand a planet, you need more than a photograph. You need tools, and the right ones. Mars rovers are not just cameras on wheels, they are mobile laboratories. The Perseverance rover carries a suite of advanced imaging tools, including MarsCam Z, SuperCam, and the Sherlock system. These instruments do more than snap pictures. They reveal texture, composition, and structure in ways the human eye never could. MarsCam Z is a stereoscopic camera that captures images in multiple wavelengths. It can zoom in on distant targets, take 3D shots, and help build digital terrain models. SuperCam uses lasers to vaporize rock and read the light signature, revealing what minerals are present. Sherlock, with its spectrometer and camera combo, searches for organic compounds. Together, these tools allow scientists to examine objects in extraordinary detail. A rock that looks mysterious from a distance might, under scrutiny, turn out to be volcanic basalt or sedimentary shale. There's no room for illusion, just data. Every face or skull seen in raw photos is put through this rigorous lens. This is how NASA separates fact from fiction. Technology sees what the eye cannot. And thanks to these tools, we know more about Mars than ever before. Not just what it looks like, but what it's made of. Still, even with science at the helm, curiosity never sleeps. Over the past two decades, Mars missions have returned thousands of images, and with them, dozens of supposed anomalies. Online communities often point to rocks resembling tools, bones, or buildings. Each image sparks a new round of speculation, but time after time, scientific review reveals the same thing: natural formations misinterpreted by eager eyes. Some of the more famous discoveries include a rock shaped like a spoon, another resembling a doorway, and even one nicknamed the Martian Woman. All of these were quickly examined and explained. The spoon? A thin piece of eroded rock, likely shaped by wind. The doorway? Just a natural fracture in a layered cliff. The woman? A small rock casting a long shadow at the right time of day. NASA doesn't hide these images. They're all public. In fact, scientists often encourage people to look at raw photos, hoping it sparks interest in real geology. But public interpretation often outpaces scientific patience. What starts as curiosity can spiral into conspiracy. Still, each misunderstood image brings new attention to Mars, and to the tools we use to explore it. What matters is not just what we see, but how we understand what we see. And behind every photo lies a deeper truth, waiting to be uncovered by more than just vision. When viral images of Martian faces and skulls flood the internet, NASA often finds itself in a strange position, balancing public curiosity with scientific clarity. Sensational headlines grab attention, but they rarely reflect what the data shows. The agency typically responds with patience, offering detailed breakdowns and comparisons to Earth geology. Scientists don't mock those who see faces or structures. They understand how human perception works. Instead, they focus on education. They explain erosion, sediment layers, and the effects of lighting. They release higher resolution images, 3D terrain models, and chemical analyses. Every time a myth spreads, science counters with context. Still, it's not always easy. Sensationalism spreads faster than science. And while fringe theories might attract viewers, they often drown out the real discoveries. Findings about Mars's climate, water history, and geology. That's where scientific outreach becomes vital. By engaging with the public, researchers can guide interest toward real questions. Was there life? How did Mars lose its atmosphere? What does its rock record truly tell us? In the end, science doesn't try to kill wonder. It refines it, because the truth, when fully understood, is more fascinating than fiction. So what do these faces and skulls actually reveal? Not signs of ancient civilizations, but evidence of a dynamic planet shaped by time, wind, and impact. Each oddly shaped rock, each illusionary structure, tells part of the story. They speak not of alien architects, but of erosion, volcanism, and long-lost water. Mars has changed drastically over billions of years. What was once a wetter, possibly habitable world is now dry and frozen. But its rocks remember. By studying them, scientists have traced the presence of ancient riverbeds, discovered clay deposits, and found organic molecules buried beneath the surface. These clues hint that Mars might once have supported microbial life, not grand monuments, but microscopic survivors. The so-called face on Mars may be a trick of shadow and shape, but it triggered decades of exploration. It drew eyes to a distant planet and raised questions worth asking. And in chasing illusions, humanity found something more enduring. The drive to understand, not just believe. Mars is still speaking, not in statues or messages, but in data, dust, and stone. And those who listen carefully are hearing the real story unfold.